This video will explain motorcycle safety and the best techniques to get the most out of your bike's brakes in emergency situations. What happens when a biker applies his brakes? Here is an illustration to explain the physics of traction of a motorcycle tire on the road in a braking situation. Imagine a motorcycle tire on the pavement. Not the entire bike, just the tire standing upright. If we try to pull it across the road with no weight on the tire, it slides pretty easily. Now, let's add some weight to the top of the tire and try and slide it across asphalt. It takes a lot more energy to slide the tire with weight on it. In other words, the tire has a lot more friction, traction, or grip on the road when there is weight on it. If you add more weight, you get more traction. A motorcycle has a certain weight distribution designed by its manufacturer. Let's assume that a bike has 75% of the weight on the back tire and 25% on the front tire. Assume the bike is rolling along and the brakes are applied. Notice that the front shocks begin to contract as the weight of the bike shifts forward, putting more pressure on the front tire. And in keeping with our earlier discovery of the relationship between weight and traction, the traction on the front tire of the bike increases and the rear tire traction decreases. So the result of the weight shifting to the front tire is that the rider can now apply even more front brake power due to the shifting weight on that tire than he could a moment before. And as the rider uses more front brake, then more weight shifts forward, increasing the traction for the front tire, which enables more of the front brake to be used. This is why the front brake is so much more powerful than the rear brake on motorcycles. This is why most bikes have two large brake discs on the front wheel and a single small disc on the rear. It's simply using the laws of inertia and weight shift to stop your bike. Just because the front tire is so effective, this is not a reason to ignore your rear brake. If your back tire is on the ground, then use that brake too. In an emergency, every inch matters. So in an emergency situation, why only use 70% or even 95% of your front braking power? If both tires are on the pavement, then they both have some traction. So in an emergency, use all you can to avoid a crash. Should you use both brakes in a routine stop? Yes, this is a good habit. This habit will save your life when you must make an emergency stop. If you routinely use just one brake, then when the idiot car pulls out in front of you, what are you gonna do? You're gonna do what you always do. So always make flawless stops by using both brakes. Use your right foot. Make sure it stays on the brake all the way to a stop and with no padding at the end. Also, be in first gear by the time you stop. If you do it right every time, you'll do it right when it really counts. And what about downshifting and using your engine in an emergency stop? Consider that engine braking works on the rear tire and rear wheel, which means you'll have less weight on it than your front tire. Therefore, it's not as effective, but it still has some value. In an emergency, don't lay down your bike. Your rubber tires have much better traction on the road than the plastic, chrome, and steel. So keep your motorcycle upright. Use the brakes and tires or swerve around the problem. Don't dump your bike. This also puts you in a very vulnerable position, that being your body laying on the road so it could be hit or run over by a car or a truck. So let's put it all together. How do you stop in the shortest possible distance? You use both brakes. You progressively increase the pressure on the front brake. This causes the weight to shift forward and gives you more traction on your front wheel so you can brake harder. You use light pressure on the rear brake because there isn't much traction back there due to the weight shifting forward. You squeeze the clutch, you tap on the shifter until your left foot goes down to the road just before you stop. So, what is the difference from an emergency stop and a routine stop? Only in the amount of pressure used on the brakes. Everything else is the same. It must be the same because you want it to be automatic in an emergency. The only way to make it happen automatically is to do it the same way every time. Remember, repetition is the mother of skill, and drive safely.